Hi, my name is Carly McAvoy, and today I am talking about expressions and equations again. A little review, and it should probably say expressions versus equations, so we want to make sure that you understand the difference between the two. Expressions can be simplified, but not solved. To solve means to find out the value of the variable, and we don't have an equal sign when we're working with expressions, so we can't solve. We simplify expressions, which means we get rid of parentheses and combine like terms. Now, like terms, remember, have the same variable or variables to the same power. That's what we mean by like terms. So expressions, all we can do with expressions are simplify them, right? We simplify expressions. We cannot solve expressions. So simplify these expressions. The best thing to do would be to try these on your own and then turn the video back on and see how you did. Well, what I'm going to do is, since there's no parentheses to get rid of, I'm going to look at the like terms. The like terms here are 5x and minus 8x. Now, maybe by now you know that if you have 5 and you take 8 away, then you're down 3 or negative 3. Which is a perfect way to think about it, and that's how I would think about it. But you could also rewrite your subtraction as addition. Remember, change subtraction to addition, change the sign of the following term, and then combine those. So what do you have more? You have more negatives. How many more? 3. So it's negative 3x. Again, that rewriting that is an optional step. Now I still have plus y, and I can't add those together. Because remember, like terms have the same variable. These do not have the same variable, so I can't combine those. I can just stop there. That's my simplified version. Notice no equal sign. I don't know what x equals. I don't know what y equals. I haven't solved for anything. I just made this. I just cleaned it up a little bit. Simplifying is like cleaning up as much as you can. Okay, second one, there are parentheses, so we want to get rid of the parentheses. You get rid of the parentheses by distributing. And so I'm going to distribute, but what am I actually distributing here? Not the 8. The 8 has nothing to do with that. What I'm actually multiplying by is negative 3. I'm going to take negative 3 times n. I could write that as plus negative 3n, or I could write it as minus 3n. Those mean the same thing. And then negative 3 times positive 4. Again, I could write that as plus negative 12. Or I could write it as minus 12. Those are the same because I can always change subtraction to addition. That's why I could write it either way. It's up to you. Now I want to combine like terms. This term right here, this n term, there's no other n terms. That's the only one that I have. And then I have like terms, though, with the numbers. They both are constant, so I can just say, okay, what about 8 minus 12? If I have 8 and I try to take 12 away, I'm going to be in the hole by 4 or negative 4. Again, you could rewrite like we did here in order to do that, or you can leave it that way. So one of the questions I always get is, why do you know to put the n term first, or how do you, and does it matter? In the end, you're going to be able to give your answers in either order. So a perfectly acceptable answer here would be negative 4 minus 3n. That's also the same. But what we do in algebra typically is we write the terms with variables first and then the constant terms. So that's the habit I'm in. And I'd like you to get in that habit if you can remember. But again, it's not vital if you forget. Okay, then the next one is simplify. And we have something a little more complicated here. This is a two different parentheses. And the thing that I wanted to show you for sure in this one was that we have to distribute a negative here, and there's no number associated with it. So what do you do in that case? Well, first of all, let's distribute our negative 6. So we're going to take the negative 6 times 3y. A negative times a positive is a negative, so I have negative 18y. Then negative 6 times a minus 1. A minus and a negative have the same meaning. So when I multiply a negative times a negative, I get a positive 6. What am I actually distributing here? When it's a minus, I'm actually distributing a negative 1, even though we don't see the 1, but we assume it's there. So what I have is negative 1 times 5y, which is negative 5y. Again, negative and subtraction can be interchanged because we can always write negative as subtraction. So we can think of it either way because it's going to have the same effect whichever way we work it in the problem. Negative 1 times positive 6, a negative times a positive is a negative, so I can write that as minus 6. I could also have written that as plus a negative 6. Those two things would be the same, right? Now I'm going to go back and combine like terms. You don't have to rewrite them side by side, but I'm going to do it because I want you to see that when you have a minus sign in front of the 5y, that's part of the term. So when I rewrite it, that minus sign has to come along with it. And here I have a positive in front of this 6, so that comes along, and I have a minus here, so that comes along. So if I rewrite those, I always want to make sure and bring the sign along with it. Negative 18y minus 5 is negative 23y. We keep the y's, and we just combine the coefficients or those numbers that are multiplying the variable. You can do that on your calculator, negative 18 and minus 5, or you can do it in your head, but it's going to be a total of 23 negatives. And here we have opposites, positive 6 and negative 6, and so those just drop out, and we're left with negative 23y. Notice in all of these expressions that I'm simplifying, I'm not solving. I, in the end, don't know what the variable equals. I don't have enough information to figure that out. I'm just rewriting this in a simplified way. And now I'm going to combine like terms here. I've got 8b and 2b. I have 8 and I add 2 more, I get 10. And I have negative 5 and negative 6. Those are like terms, both constants. 5 negatives and 6 more negatives. And that's going to be a negative 11. And that's complete because this b cannot be added onto this term. There's no b here, so they're not like terms. And that's as far as I can go. Okay, I hope you have a fantastic day.